गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई प्रोफेसर हर्षा नंगामणि टीचिंग यू द सब्जेक्ट नेम दैट इज पाइथन. सो आफ्टर इन माय फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी जस्ट सॉ अबाउट द व्हाट इज द पाइथन एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द पाइथन और एंड द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ द पाइथन एंड in between that we have to learn how we can python install in our pc. so basically it is very easy to install the python in our basic laptop or computer. that is nothing but we have to just download the python compiler from the site like www.python.org. the all the versions of the python are available on this website. you have to just go with this website www.python.org and just download the latest version of the python, which is nothing but 3.9.3, which is for Windows 10 with 64 bit. If you having the operating system 7 or XP and all, or the next version of Windows, and the operating system must be for this version having the 64 bit. If it is lesser than it, then please search on www.python.org the matching version for this Windows and the bits of the operating system. Okay, so basically from that you have to just download the version of Python and then install it by double clicking on the icon which is a setup file of the Python. Okay, after if you won't be means not understood the how we can got the Python compiler, so just search on the net PyCharm and then install it on the PC for running purpose or for the practicing purpose. So basically today's our topic, it is not installing the Python and all, but if you want to practice the Python programming, then you have to download the Python and install it on your PC or laptop. So basically today's my topic from the Python, it is nothing but the comments. So basically when we learn about any programming language, so when we write the programming content and we just want to this particular line does not recognize by the compiler, so that time we have to write the comment line, or when we use the programming content and write it line by line, but after some time we just forget what should be this program and what should be done by this program. So basically we just write the some sentence or some line that after that reading we just make sure that particular line what will be done by this particular program. So at that purpose we just use the comment line in our program so that the particular compiler does not recognize that particular sentence for the compilation, so it will be not compiled by the compiler. So Python having such type of the comment statement or comment symbol, after giving that symbol the Python compiler does not recognize that particular line for the compilation. So here the hash is used for giving the comment line to that particular program so that compiler does not recognize that particular line for compilation. So it is a comment line. How we will give the comment in Python? By using this. Okay, so after that the data types, like other languages Python also having its own data type. So basically the basic data types are nothing but the string, integer and float. So string it is nothing but the data type which in which we just store the string values. What is mean by the string? It is nothing but the collection of the characters, digit, special symbol, space, but it is enclosed in the double quotation mark. Exactly, it is enclosed in double quotation mark, but in Python we just enclosed in single quotation also. So the combination of the characters, digits, special symbol or space enclosed in single or double quotation mark, it is nothing but the string. So when we assign that particular thing on the variable, so it become a string variable. So basically the first type, it is nothing but the string. Then second one is a float. Float, it is nothing but a numeric number, but it is compulsorily have a decimal point. So it is nothing but the float. That means the variable of float type which store the value of integer type, means digit type, but it having must having the decimal point. And vice versa, in integer we just store the number numeric form or digit in that particular variable, but which is doesn't having any dot, that means any decimal point. So float, it is a digit or number which having the decimal point, but integer which does not have the decimal point. So we just start with the string. I already told you what is the meaning of the string. String, it is nothing but the collection of alphabets, digit, special symbol, which enclosed, and spaces also, which enclosed in single quotation or double quotation mark. So it is the example of string. String 1 equals to, in single quotation, GS College of Commerce, Vardha. Okay, so it is the variable, it is the variable of a string. I doesn't declare that variable as a type of string. In Python, it is possible without declaration, we can just assign the particular variable according to assignment, the compiler will recognize the data type of the variable. So be comfortable that in previous languages like C, C++ and Java, we have to declare first variable and then we have to assign the particular value. But in Python, we just write the A. I doesn't specify any data type before A, but when I assign the A is equals to 10, then the compiler will recognize A has integer data type. Okay, if I assign the value like this, then compiler will recognize it is a float data type. If I give the single quotation mark with the string, so it become a string, and it will the compiler will understand it is a string type of variable. So here I just create a string 1 equals to, so the compiler will understood that is a string type of variable and it store the string value. Okay, so here s equals to hello Python. I as per I said in earlier, like Python having the single quotation mark on the string or double quotation mark. So it is the example when we write the string in single quotation mark or double quotation mark. So what happened in the compiler when we assign or create a string variable with the value? So like this, hello Python, it is a string which is enclosed in double quotation mark. So hello Python. Python compiler manage the memory and store our string like this, like a single dimension array. Okay, so it is start from 0. The array start from 0. The index position of that particular array, it is nothing but the 0, and it is the length of our string. Okay, so n. So what should be the length? That is n. Okay, so it is start from the 0. So which operation we just perform on the string? So we are concatenating it, we are just putting the string in upper case or lower case, we just calculate the length of that particular string, or we just convert the numeric value into the string. So those are the operation which we perform on the string. But in Python there is one another operation, that is nothing but the slicing. Slicing means what? Slicing means we just extract the part of that particular string in simple way. How? Like this one. Okay, so one by one the operation which we perform on the string we will see. Okay, so this is the first, s in bracket 0. So this bracket indicates the array, and 0 it is nothing but the index number. So s, it is a string which having the index number 0. So the output, when we print this particular thing, then the output will give us like h. So whatever the first character present in that particular s, it is nothing but the string, so this first value will be printed. So we can rectify or retrieve the single one character with the index number of the string by using this. Okay, so after that, if I want to retrieve the last character of the string, I just say I want to retrieve the last character of the string, but I doesn't know the length of the Python, the length of the string. So I just perform this operation, like print s, it is nothing but the string value, then in bracket the length is a function s, length of s, it is a string, and minus 1, why? Because the index is start from 0 and n it is a variable. So the last character from this manipulation, we just get the last character of the string. After that, concatenating of the string. Here we use the various symbol and various methodology to concatenate or joining the string in C. So some functions we just use for concatenate joining to string, but here we just use the plus sign. Yes, the plus sign is responsible for concatenate to string in Python. This is the simple way or methodology to use or concatenate the string. So here the string 1, s1 and s2, we just concatenate by using the plus sign. So the output will be hello Python. If we store the another value in the variable, we just use the variable or a directly string here. Okay, so the concatenating is performing in Python by using the plus sign. Okay, the next is a repeating string. When we want to print the repeated string on the screen without any effort, how we can print that particular string? In before languages, we have to print that particular, repeating string printing, we have to use the looping statement or for loop, while loop in a programming, so that the repeating string will be printed. Okay, but here in Python, this simple methodology is provided, that is nothing but the multiplication sign. Yes, the multiplication sign is responsible for print that particular string in repetitive format. So here, if I just denote or just declare the variable of a string and store the string value in that particular variable, and I put the asterisk mark, that is multiplication mark, and 5. Okay, so basically the print statement will print s means the string into 5, that means 5 times. So the output of that particular thing, it is nothing but the hello, 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 up to 5 times. So Python give us the some character which is used for basic things or basic printing things, which or the operation which we perform on the string. Then next one is a size. How we will get the size of that particular string? By using the length, and it is very common function which is we already used in previous languages. But the next and new part in the Python, that is nothing but the slicing the string. Slicing means what? If we have the string in this form, so if we want to retrieve some part of the string like py or on or he, so when we want to retrieve the some part of the string from that particular string or some character from the string from that particular string, so we use the slicing of a string, and it is a new thing which is having in Python. So here this is the example, like print program, it is nothing but the string. Here we use the 3:5. Here it is a starting index of the character and it is a ending index of the character. That means from 3, means when we count that particular thing, so from 3 up to 5, those character will be extract from this particular thing. So program 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these two, starting up to 4. Means less than the ending index, so it will gives us the output gr only. Okay, the next one is 4:. That means the starting index is present but ending index is not present, so it will start from 0 1 2 3 4, like ram. So the last string will be printed. This one is starting index is 3 and ending index is 6. So 3, 4, 5. 3, G, R, A. Less than the ending index. And the next one is, that means the starting index is not available. That means the 0. It will print P, R, O, G. Less than from ending index. So this is nothing but the slicing. And we have to provide in slicing in square bracket with the starting index up to ending index. So it will print the string in between. That means the starting index, from the starting index and the less amount of the ending index. Okay. So this is the format how we use the slicing, like starting index and then colon. It will print the character from started which is given here, by the index which is given here, and ending means all. Okay, this is the both the starting and ending index is present, and here the ending starting index is 0 but ending index is given. The other one, other operation, that is lower and upper, those are the functions which is provided by the Python, which is used for converting our string into lowercase, upper into lower, and lower into upper. So lower function is used to convert our string into lowercase, but string must have given in the uppercase. So the all uppercase character are converted into lowercase character by using the lower function, as well the all lowercase character converted into uppercase character by using the uppercase function. So if those are the functions which we used for converting the length, converting the string in uppercase or lowercase. And last one is converting method, that is nothing but the string. As str, it is a function which is used for converting our numeric format into string format. That means if I write here pi is equals to 1 2 3, so now this pi become a integer value. After that, if I write the str pi, so it will convert the pi value 1, 2, 3 into a string. That means the single quotation mark or double quotation mark. So it is a function which is used to convert the numeric value into the string value. Okay. It is okay for today. What we learned today? comment line, data type, string. In string, we just how to use it, then concatenate in string, how we concatenate by using plus sign, repeating by using star means asterisk sign, then length, how, then slicing, it is very important, then converting string into uppercase to lowercase, and last one, converting any integer number into the string. Thank you.